take more activities to done today. So let there be no repeats. So in fact, all the games were unique. I have attended lots of sessions for lots of experience. So only one was repeat, which was that hula hoop. The round one. But the first game was not. But the rest of the activities were really unique. So I'm going to apply all of them. As and when required, I request Rajani to share the PDF with that can be applicable, say, for example, accountability and responsibility. This is the game and how we conduct. What is the maximum team size we can have? Minimum team size, what we can have?
Sure.
So those things can actually help me. So I was doing projective listening as well, because active listening, projective listening is all has to be part of the complete learning phase. So I was trying to relate some of the concepts that he discussed from the beginning as to how I have applied, how it would have been better, and how I'm going to implement it in future. So my feedback for the session, it's not a feedback, but it's a feed forward, what I would say. It's excellent. We had a diversity in the room, and we got to know each other's perspectives. That is a value-add greatly, because in the industry, what we generally have is the Gen Y population. Gen X is probably 20% or 30%. Now, what we are going to recruit is the Gen X, the Gen Z. Okay, so what is the kind of cultural fit that we should have, or cultural gaps that we have to bridge? So that is also very, very important. So all these games can actually be, is applicable across, whether it's Gen X, Gen Y, Gen Z.
Yeah.
So that's the plus point. So yes, I think I covered all of that.
Could be better?
What could be better?
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
She was the first one who registered for the program.